Hi there, Sergio Yegolop here for InfoWorld at IDG. Today in Smart Python, I'm going to look at the differences between the 32 and 64-bit editions of Python and how that can affect your use of third-party applications. Note that for this discussion, I'm focusing mainly on the Windows version of Python since the difference between 32 and 64-bit is most prominent there. Now, when you head to the official Python site, you'll notice that a slew of different editions of Python are available for download. One big difference is that some of them are listed as x86, while others are listed as x86-64. The x86 builds are 32-bit versions, and the x86-64 editions are 64-bit editions. Now, most computers today, especially most Windows machines, are 64-bit, and they come with a 64-bit edition of Windows. Those versions of Windows can run either the 32-bit or 64-bit versions of Python, so at first it doesn't look like there's much difference between the two. You might also be inclined to think running the 64-bit edition is overkill. One of the main advantages of the 64-bit edition of any application is that it provides access to more than 4 gigabytes of contiguous memory. Since not everybody is crunching gargantuan areas of numbers, sometimes the 32-bit version seems like all you need. Now, all this is true, but only up to a point. See, the biggest issue with 32-bit editions of Python centers around compatibility with third-party modules. Python has a huge universe of software that you can add to it by way of the pip install command, and many of these modules are pure Python and will install anywhere, but some of them require binary components to be built for specific platforms. These binaries are packaged in a format called a wheel. Sometimes you can find a precompiled wheel for a package you're looking for, but many software maintainers are not making precompiled 32-bit wheels anymore. Demand for them has faded, now that most everyone is using a 64-bit OS and a 64-bit edition of Python to go with it. So to that end, the 32-bit editions of Python are going to be harder to work with when it comes to third-party modules. They won't always have precompiled wheels for third-party modules, and this can cause unexpected interruptions in your workflow. Now, if for some reason you're stuck with the 32-bit edition, for instance, if you have some other 32-bit precompiled binary that you can't upgrade, there are workarounds. First, some kind folks have created their own 32-bit wheels for many packages that don't have them provided by default. Christopher Golke, whose site I'm showing here and linking in the video description, is one such provider. As you can see, he provides builds for a lot of projects. So let's say I wanted to install the AIO HTTP module in Python 3.9 32-bit, for which there is no pre-built binary. I have here in this folder a pre-compiled 32-bit wheel from Christopher Golke's site. I can install it into my 32-bit edition of Python 3.9 just by passing it to pip. Now, what would happen if we did not have a 32-bit wheel anywhere? In that case, pip would attempt to find build tools to create the binary on my computer. In Windows, that's the Microsoft Visual C++ compiler, and it just so happens that I have the Visual C++ tools already installed on this machine, since I use them for working with Cython. So if I run pip install AIO HTTP, and I don't use this precompiled wheel that I was using before, you're going to see an extra step here where the installer runs the build tools silently in the background and creates a binary. Now, if you don't have a compiler installed on your machine, this step won't work. And if you're in the doubly unfortunate position of not being able to install a compiler on that machine, you're completely out of luck. You'd either have to get a binary from somebody else or you'd have to get to another machine where you could run the compiler. So to sum up, the 64-bit edition of Python ought to be your default choice at this point, given how many people are providing precompiled binaries for it. The only time you really need to use the 32-bit edition is if you're stuck with a 32-bit operating system or if you have to force compatibility with a 32-bit component, but both of those are vanishing exceptions to this rule. That's it for this video. If you liked it, please leave a comment below. Don't forget to subscribe to the IDG Tech Talk channel, and for more Smart Python, be sure to follow us on Facebook, YouTube, and InfoWorld.com.